So I just want to echo some of the comments that have been made about the Ridge Carnival. If you've been around in the county long enough to remember when there were more carnivals, you'll know that they all had their own different feel, their different little flavor to them. The Ridge Carnival is no different. If I was going to describe the Ridge Carnival, I would say community. It is a community event, and you should definitely go down this weekend. I was able to get there opening night. Get a crab cake while you're down there. Ridge makes some great crab cakes at their carnivals. It's wonderful.
They sell out fast.
They do. Only Friday and Saturday nights this year at the carnival, too. So if you show up on a Thursday like I did, you won't get a crab cake. But the pizza was good. I was also able to attend the Foundation for Heroes 9/11 event and read a list of names. It's always a powerful, moving event. So thank you to all the organizers of that. There's a lot of work that goes into that, a lot of organization, and I really appreciate it. I was also able to attend a 9/11 service on Saturday morning out at St. Clements Island. It was organized by a youth group called Southern Maryland Roots, and it was intended to honor the first responders, and it was an incredible event. So they asked me to speak, so I was very happy to. Senator Bailey spoke, Emergency Services Director Steve Walker spoke, Maryland State Trooper Sergeant Casey Ruth, Captain Steve Hall from our Sheriff's Department, and Board of Education member Rita Weaver spoke. It was just a very moving event on an incredibly beautiful day, and the island looked incredible. It was just great all around, and so thank you to all the people who helped make that possible. It was really good. Today's a little different. Obviously, I'm sitting here, and I want to thank Commissioner Guy for letting me sit in his seat while he's out of town, but we also started later today than we normally do, because this morning we had our CalVex drill. This happens every 2 years. It's a FEMA drill in order to just be prepared in case there's an accident at the nuclear power plant. So what's interesting about that is communities that have nuclear power plants like we do here, this was a cross-county drill going on. So Calvert County was involved, we were involved, Dorchester County was involved, because they're in the zone that if something happened, they need to be involved and be ready. And the communities that have these events and these regular practices are better prepared for any kind of emergency that happens. And it's just fascinating for me to be able to sit there and see all of our great county employees, state employees, just people from every different department and branch that can be involved, working together to solve the problems, to solve the scenario that was thrown at them. It started off as a small little leak, and then in the scenario, this is just a drill, just a scenario, there was a plane crash and a sinkhole, and they adapted and they worked together, and it was incredible. Now, if you've ever been in our emergency operations center, Mr. Gerald Gardner is our emergency manager who handles anytime there's an emergency in the county. He's the one in charge. Everyone answers to him. But today, I want to give a shout out to Amy Bledsoe, because she led it today. She did a great job. So thank you, Amy. Thank you to everyone who was involved, because it was really good.